From the Tribune News Network, this is Newsbreak. I'm Krishna Russell. Ghana native Joseph Amaher is suing the government for $10.6 million with interest for illegally detaining him for nearly 7 years at the Carmichael Road Detention Center, during which time he endured poor treatment where he was physically, emotionally, and psychologically abused. Of that sum, $6,890,000 is for false imprisonment, $2 million for constitutional damages by way of compensation and vindication, $1 million for exemplary damages, $500,000 for aggravated damages, $300,000 for assault and battery, and $700 for special damages, his attorney Fred Smith QC has said. Last month, the government agreed to apologize and compensate Mr. Amaher for unlawfully holding him in the detention center after he traveled to the Bahamas from Jamaica for a three-week vacation in 2010. During a hearing yesterday for the assessment of damages before Justice Camille Darvo Gomez, Mr. Smith asserted that $10,690,000 was an appropriate figure to award his client to send a lightning rod of a financial message to the government that continued crimes against the civil and constitutional rights of people. With the state of emergency and current emergency order set to expire at the end of this month, Attorney General Carl Bethel said Prime Minister Dr. Hubert Minnis is now consulting with the medical community to decide the way forward. Among other restrictions due to the emergency order, New Providence currently has a nightly curfew in place from 10 p.m. to 5 a.m., but there have been complaints recently that the curfew is not being enforced. Videos have circulated on social media showing clubs in full swing after curfew hours, with no social distancing nor mask wearing being conducted. A popular promoter ran into trouble 2 weeks ago when a party was held at a property leased to him, with hundreds of people bunched together enjoying themselves without practicing any COVID-19 protocols. He was fined some $92,000 by police for breaking the emergency orders. Mr. Bethel said yesterday, quote, "Cabinet has not made a determination, and I raised the issue with the Prime Minister, who has indicated that he wishes to have some serious discussions with the medical community to get their advice. He's not prepared to commit to any particular course of action until he has done so." The pilot of a Piper Navajo plane that went down in waters off of South Bimini last month said he blacked out and cannot recall key details of the incident, which claimed the life of his son. The Air Accident Investigation Authority's preliminary report into the matter said, quote, "The pilot stated that after he selected gear up, he proceeded to climb to 1,200 feet, and his next memory was being in the water with the crew door blown open, and two Bahamian men shouted at me from approximately 300 yards away on land, 'Sir, are you okay? Do you need help?' The plane left the South Bimini International Airport at night on April 16th and was headed for the Opa-locka Airport in Florida. While the pilot sustained injuries, his son died as a result of the crash sequence and subsequent submersion in the waters at the end of the runway environment. The Ministry of Health has said 62 new COVID-19 cases were confirmed yesterday. That is 45 in New Providence, 4 in Grand Bahama, 2 in Abaco, 2 in the Berry Islands, 1 in Inagua, 6 in Andras, and 2 with locations pending. This after the ministry confirmed that there were 52 new cases of COVID-19 on Wednesday. 45 of those cases were in New Providence. As it stands, the country has now seen 10,773 cases of COVID-19. Further, the Ministry of Health has said it is aware of a message circulating on social media purporting to be an urgent and important request for persons vaccinated with the AstraZeneca COVID-19 vaccine in the Bahamas. The message appealed to persons experiencing COVID-like symptoms for more than 3 days to share personal details and information about the vaccine administered, the ministry said in a statement. The general public is therefore advised that this message did not originate with the surveillance unit of the Ministry of Health and has not been approved for communication. Consequently, the Ministry of Health strongly advises the public to seek information from reliable sources, such as the Ministry of Health, the Office of the Prime Minister, the World Health Organization, and the Pan American Health Organization, and guard against receiving and/or sharing misinformation about COVID-19 and the vaccine. Your complete news and information source, this is the Tribune News Network. In international news, the recovery of America's job market hit a pause last month as many businesses, from restaurants and hotels to factories and construction companies, struggled to find enough workers to catch up with a rapidly strengthening economic rebound. Employers added just 266,000 jobs in April, sharply lower than in March and far fewer than economists had expected. With viral cases declining and states and localities easing restrictions, the recovery from the pandemic recession has been so fast that many businesses have been caught flat-footed in the face of surging consumer demand. Countries worldwide wrestling with new coronavirus surges are trying to ensure they aren't hit by an Indian-style disaster. They face many of the same risks, including large populations that have shirked restrictions and fragile health systems shaken under the strain. In a province along the Nile in southern Egypt, hospitals have been flooded with COVID-19 patients, a main hotspot and a third spike swelling across the country. Doctors in Sohag province warn the health system there could collapse, even as the government rushes with new supplies. The Tribune's AccuWeather update, a service of Bahamas Power and Light Company. A prefrontal trough is producing pockets of unsettled weather over portions of the northwest Bahamas. Meanwhile, a weakening ridge of high pressure generates gentle to moderate breezes over the islands. There is the possibility of waterspout activity in the northwest Bahamas. In the northwest Bahamas, it'll be variably cloudy and warm, with scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms through tonight. Expect gusty winds and higher seas in or near heavy showers and thunderstorms. Winds south southwest at 10 to 15 knots over open waters ahead of the front, shifting west to northwest at 10 to 15 knots behind the front, but falling light and variable at times. Seas 2 to 4 feet over the ocean. In the central and southeast Bahamas, it'll be sunny and hot with a slight chance of a stray shower, partly cloudy and warm tonight with isolated showers and a few possible thunderstorms, mainly in the central Bahamas. Winds east to southeast at 10 to 15 knots, seas 2 to 4 feet over the ocean. We'll have a daytime high temperature of 90 degrees and an overnight low temperature of 70. The sun will set this afternoon at 7:41 and will rise tomorrow morning at 6:29. That's Newsbreak. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper, now on the streets. Or stay up to date online at Tribune242.com.